In this lecture, I am going to tell you how you can integrate Jenkins with Test Project Automation tool. Couple of agendas are there in this lecture, and I am going to tell you what are those agendas. So today's agenda is that we will download Jenkins and install Jenkins in our local machine. Also, if you want, you can download and install Jenkins in a web server or any server you have. For this lecture, I will prefer to install Jenkins in my local machine. Once you have downloaded and installed Jenkins in your local machine, the next step will be configuration of Jenkins. I will tell you how you can configure the Jenkins so that Jenkins will be up and running for in your system. The next thing is that we will install the plugins required, and also I will tell you the Test Project Automation plugin that is required to integrate Jenkins with the Test Project Automation tool. Once we are done with that, I will also tell you about how you can create an API key in your Test Project Automation tool and integrate Jenkins with the Test Project Automation tool. And also I will show you how the reports generated. So let us begin the session of integrating Jenkins, which is a DevOps tool, with Test Project Automation. The first thing that you need to do is that you have to open a website, Google, and from the Google search engine you will find the Jenkins. Just write download Jenkins, and the first website that will be presented in front of you is Jenkins official website. From there you can download Jenkins. Click on the first link and go on download. Click on the download button. Once you click on the download button, you have a lot of options, whether it will be a Docker or Azure or where you want to deploy. So I will prefer the WAR file. Just click on the last one, WAR file. You will have a Jenkins WAR file in your machine.
Wait for the download to complete and then
create a folder inside the C program files and create a folder named Jenkins. And in that folder, put the WAR file in the Jenkins folder. Once we are done with all these things, just go to CMD or ConEMU and run a setup piece of command, which I will give you in the description. Once you write those command, the Jenkins will be up and running in your system, and you will get an initial password which you need to copy it, which will be used for the setup and configuration of Jenkins from the browser. So you will have to wait for the initial password, and also you will have to wait for the message that Jenkins is up and running successfully. So this is the initial password, just copy it from here. Alternatively you have the path also from where the password can be visible. You can copy that path also, and see in the last line we have a message coming up that Jenkins is up and running, which means our Jenkins installation is complete and it is completely up and running in my system. Now comes the Jenkins configuration part. To configure the Jenkins, the first thing that you need to do is that to open a web browser and write localhost 8080/Jenkins. Then you will see a unlock Jenkins where you need to paste the password that you have copied. I will also copy the password from the folder that is displayed here. I will copy the folder and I will directly go to that folder path, and a text file will be presented in front of me. So I will go to the text file and copy the secret key. So once you copy the secret key, just do nothing, just go and paste it in the administrative password area and click on next or configure. Now you will have two options: install suggested plugin, select plugin to install, or you want to choose. So I will just go and click on the install suggested plugin. Now this will take some time, so I will skip this part for some time, and I will come back once again when all the installed plugin or the selected plugin has been successfully installed. Suggested plugin has been successfully installed. So almost the plugins have installed, and it is still in some of them are in progress, but almost it is done. And we will wait for some more time to installation to complete. Once it is complete, we have the option to create the first admin user. So give a username, password, confirm password, email, Once you are done, click on save and continue. Click start and start using Jenkins. So Jenkins is ready, and now you can click on start using Jenkins. So this is the Jenkins dashboard we have. To come to the third one where we have to install the test project plugin. So to install the test project plugin, just go to manage Jenkins and come to the down and click on manage plugin. In the manage plugin, we have some tabs called update, available, installed, advanced. So just go to the available tab. Once you are in the available tab, click on the search, and in the search write test project automation tool. Or simply write test project. Write the test project without a gap here, because if you give a gap, you will not able to find it. Write test project. Just click on it and verify that it is the same plugin that we are going to install. You can check it from the prerequisite that you have to have an account on test project at testproject.io. That means this is the plugin we are looking for. Just go back and do the same step once again. Write test project in the available tab. Once you get the plugin, just click on the checkbox and install without restart. We don't want Jenkins to get restarted at this moment, so I will just give a checkbox, click, and then I will click on the button install without restart. Plugin installation is complete and it is writing success and the status is success. So our Jenkins installation is done. Now we have to integrate Jenkins with the test project automation tool.
Now open the test project website which I have already registered. Use the credentials use the same credentials to log in with the test project website. Once you are available on the dashboard of a test project automation, you go to the integration tab on the top menu bar. From the integration tab, click on API, and from there click on create API key. Once you click on create API key, you have to give a name for this API. I will give the name Jenkins API, and I also have to give the modifier. That means whether this API is going to be an unrestricted API or this API key is going to be only for a project specific API. We can create a project specific API by clicking on any of the projects which is from the below, and also we can create an unrestricted API by API key from checking the box unrestricted. At this moment, I want this API key to be accessed from a specific project, so I will click on that specific project checkbox. Once you are done, click on finish. And the API key has been generated. Copy the API key and go back to your Jenkins. In the Jenkins, go to the manage Jenkins and now go to the configure system. So at this time you have to click on manage. So this time you have to click manage Jenkins and go to the configure system. In the configure system, you have an option called test project automation, because we have installed the plugin test project automation plugin. So find that, and inside that you have option to paste the API key. Just paste the API key there. You can also click on the verbose checkbox so that you get additional logs. At this time I don't need to click on the verbose, so I will paste the API key. Once you are done, click on apply and save to get the changes affected. Now we will create the job. To create the job, click on create job and give the job a name, and this job will be a freestyle project. So I will give the name test project, and this will be a freestyle project. So I will click on freestyle project. Once you are done, click on OK. Now we have to configure the job. Now to configure the job, we have to go to build. Click on build and add build steps. Once you click on build, click on add build steps and then click on run test project job. These options are coming because you have installed and configured the plugin. So once you have clicked on the run test project jobs, you have different options to create the project, to select the project ID, job ID, agent ID and everything. So I will show you the details. Go to home in the test project, and if we want to run the my first test project, this suit, so that is the name is already getting displayed. Okay, the project name is my first project, and as we have given access Jenkins to access only my first project, so that project name is getting displayed on the Jenkins. Also you can copy the project ID from here and match it from here. See the same ID. The job ID is the daily execution because we have already created the job for this project. So this will be the job ID. And this is the agent where you want to run, Shantan's agent or Shantan's Mac. I want to run on Shantan's agent, so I will pick the Shantan's agent. So we have done with the project ID, job ID, and now wait to finish will be 0 seconds. To get the help, you can click on the help menu, that is a question mark. It is saying that minimum value is 10 or 0 for don't wait. So we will enter 0 here. Now you can, if you want, you can have a mail notification. Okay, and if you don't need a mail notification, you can skip this part. Also, we have a mail notification from the test project automation tool. So we don't need at this moment, but still I am giving this. If any kind of unstable build is there, just send the mail from Jenkins also. Now this project is ready. Come to the dashboard and click on build. Before giving the build, let's test whether the test project agent is running or not. My test project agent is not running, so I will wait for my test project agent to come online. See, it is saying that online is 0 and agent is 0. So my test project agent is not running and I have to wait for the test project agent to come online. It is saying that the Shantan's agent is starting. That means it is getting started and we have to wait for the agent to become in a ready state to start the execution. Now it is ready. So I will just go and check one more thing, which is a public agent and a private agent. What is a public agent? Public agent means this agent can be run from Jenkins, and private agent means this agent will not respond to Jenkins and this agent will only respond to test project automation builds. Okay, so I will change public to private and private to public according to my need. Thus this build will going to be run from Jenkins, so this agent needs to be a public agent. Now we have started the build and we can check that the build is success, as we have given no time to wait to 0. So that means it will not wait for whatever the build result. It will just start the build and it will say that my build is running. You can see that in the test project monitor section, we can see that the daily execution job ran by Jenkins, and we can see the progress bar also. So our Jenkins is giving the execution for running the test project automation. The current target machine is Firefox, as we are doing a cross browser testing. So initially it has started with Chrome and then it has moved to Firefox as whatever written in the test step. You can see that in the background it is running on Firefox. Now the execution is finished and our agent is again online, and that means our execution is done. Now go to the test project mail. I have received the mail from the test project, and in the mail you can see that, and also you can check in the email report that the build has been run by Jenkins. Now go to the test project reports, and in the reports go to the daily execution job. Go to the daily execution job and you can see that it has been executed by CI Jenkins build. This is how we can integrate Jenkins with the test project automation tool.